Welcome back, dropouts. You're listening to The Bloodstream, the podcast where I reach into the various streaming services and see what piranha gnaws my hand off this week. I am your host, Jason Gray, your guide to the weird and the feared. And this week, the movie that caught my eye and annoyed me the most, which shouldn't be my criteria but seems to keep happening, was a movie called Hulk Blood Tapes. Now you're probably thinking to yourself, aha, Jason is a huge comic nerd. Hulk Blood Tapes, this must have something to do with the character The Incredible Hulk, right? You could not be more wrong, and I even knew going into this that had nothing to do with what the movie was about. I'll get more into what the title means in a minute, but for now, just so you know, nothing comic book whatsoever anywhere in this movie. Instead, let me just read the synopsis. Five friends on a road trip to see their favorite band are detoured along the way, and when they become lost, they find they're willing to do anything to survive the night. So Hulk Blood is the name of the band these kids are going to see, and I did a little bit of research, and it is the name of a real band. They were operating from around the mid-1990s to the mid-2000s, and they broke up somewhere around 2005. In this movie, there's supposedly a reunion tour that these people are off to see because they're huge fans and their favorite band is getting back together for this once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. Sure, fine, whatever. The movie actually opens up with some of the worst-looking footage I've ever seen, and it's a news broadcast with the anchor talking to three of the people we're about to meet and follow through the rest of this movie, and it is utterly baffling. And I am terrified that this movie is going to look this bad for the next hour and change. Fortunately, once it gets to the kids' found footage tape, it looks like pretty much every other found footage movie, and made with relatively decent cameras. Which makes absolutely no sense to me. Why is the news broadcast that is supposedly of professional quality, looks like it is filmed through cheesecloth, dipped in coffee, and covered in Vaseline, and then goes to footage filmed by amateurs, at least in the parlance of the movie? Like, if you're going to do that trick, shouldn't it be reversed? I mean, I don't want to watch an hour-long movie that looks like absolute garbage, even though if we're being fair, I have, repeatedly, but at least that concept would make more sense, right? But before we get to the actual footage, the three survivors talk a little about things to set it up just a little bit, and one of them mentions that it's something incredible that they've caught on tape. Okay, I'm intrigued. It doesn't pay off, spoilers, but you've got my attention ever so briefly. And once the actual footage starts, we do basically the normal getting people together in the car and driving off, and you know how this stuff goes, and it goes for a while. As far as these sorts of scenes are, it's not that bad. It's more tolerable than, say, the Real Cases of Shadow People movie I did way back at the start of Blood Droplets. Way back at the beginning, I say, like it wasn't just six episodes and an entire year ago. And this is also where we find out that Hulk Blood is the name of the band they're going to see. And the name Hulk Blood Tapes makes zero sense for this movie. It is the name of the band these people are going to see and never get to. So why is it called that? Moving on. They drive along for a while, and at some point, the guy behind the wheel, Jared, swerves, and he's either trying to miss something, loses control of the car, something goes wrong, a tie rod pops, who knows. The car swerves, they do some really shaky camera work, some really cheap off-the-rack sound effects to simulate the car crash, and once the camera stops shaking and we can see what's going on, we see they have crashed the car and somehow have gone off a cliff and survived. They try to establish that they've gone off a cliff, but they don't do a terribly good job of it. They just kind of point vaguely off camera like there's an alien invasion off there somewhere. And the whole reason for them going off a cliff is it trying to establish a reason that they don't just go right back to the road. Which, once we get further into the movie, I will point out, still makes zero sense. So everyone's freaking out. One of the people along with the trip died in the crash. But on top of all that, Jared's girlfriend Nikki has also injured her ribs somewhat. So thanks to all the adrenaline, the car crash, what they're going to do Everyone's yelling at everyone else. Someone shouts at Matt to stop filming, and Matt shouts back the justification for why we are still filming anything beyond this point is that he promised he would film the entire trip, which is the worst justification I have seen in a found footage movie in a very long time. So the main thrust of the argument is what they're going to do next. Stay at the car, or travel into the woods, because they can't climb up the cliff. Because of Nikki's injuries, some of them want to stay at the car, which makes sense. Others want to go deeper into the woods to try to find help, which makes very little sense. Someone says, wait, we should go into the woods and leave a note at the car. But someone else says, well, we have nothing to write on. I'm sorry, but you have pointed out repeatedly that you are taking multiple boxes of Cookie Crisp on the trip with you. You could tear off the label from that giant jug of Jim Beam to write on. One of you is wearing a plain white t-shirt that you could rip off and write on if you were absolutely desperate and had nothing else, which, okay, to be fair, we're in the woods, night is coming, it's not warm out, so that's not your best choice, but all I'm saying is you have options if you really wanted to leave a note. Now, if you said, we have nothing to write with, I might be with you. But even then, you could come up with something if you were absolutely desperate. They walk for a while, they argue for a while, and eventually they reach a point where they're like, you know what, this isn't working, let's turn around and head back to the car. Oh, sweet God, no, they're pulling a Factory of Paranormal. So since night is falling, they haven't found their way back to the car, they make a fire. At least the group of chuckle fucks is capable of that much. But since you clearly know how to make a fire, once again, the smart move would have been to stay at the car, make a fire, and someone on the road, which is literally just at the top of the cliff you fell off, would see smoke rising out of the forest. They might not have known it was a person down there, but it would have gotten someone's attention at some point. You could have stayed warm, you would have had a signal smoke going into the air, you wouldn't be moving Nikki around, who is probably dying from internal bleeding at this point, and I've said this before, with so many found footage movies, if you have your characters questioning why someone is filming, you get one. I allow poking at that much of the concept of these movies, but if you're doing it over and over and over again, you're breaking the contract that the audience has agreed to sit down and watch these movies, which ultimately makes very little sense when no one puts the camera down. We've accepted this, we're here for the ride, don't constantly poke at the logic of your own film. That's all I'm asking. So, they settle around the fire for the night, and it's a nearly 10-minute scene of just sitting and talking and more yelling, really. And Matt continues to defend his decision by saying, this is the reason we're here, to film it, to show the world. Show the world what? Stoners wandering into the forest to get lost and high? Oh, stop the presses! We're here to film this and show the world is the sort of thing you say when you've got Bigfoot on your ass and you have filmed documented footage of him. Or the Blair Witch has just eaten your friend's face. Or aliens have just abducted your girlfriend. But not when you yell a lot in the woods. You have documented jack shit. And Jack, he's back at the car. Speaking of the Blair Witch, since this is a found footage movie, Jared takes some time to do your typical confession screen talking right to the camera to talk about his guilt for getting Parker killed in the car crash. The next day they continue walking, Nikki's not doing too hot, and somehow they find their way back to the cliff. Maybe it's a really long cliff and it kind of curves a bit. Fine, I can buy that. Which leads to more yelling of what to do because one of them wants to climb the cliff, which is a better idea than anyone else has at this point. And these people are so at each other's throats, and they have only been lost in the woods not even 24 hours. Another night falls, we get more confessionals from, I think, every single character in the movie by this point. Nicole being on her deathbed and wanting to leave a goodbye message to her family, I can at least allow that. And with all these confessionals, wandering around in the woods, not having a map, acting like general fools for no good reason, this is Blair Witch without anything supernatural or interesting about it. Actually, to be fair, there is one interesting thing in this movie, and that's what happens to Nicole. Because of her injuries, because she's probably going to die soon anyways, and because she's slowing them down, Ben takes it upon himself to strangle Nicole in her sleep and kill her as a bit of mercy, and that leads to his confessional. Matt's confessional, if you have been paying attention, should not be at all surprised, is pretty much summed up as, "I'm sorry I'm filming all this." Well, you know what you can do? Turn off the freaking camera. Understandably, the next day, everyone is ready to give up. Jared, because he's responsible for two people being dead, one of which being his girlfriend. Ben is kind of done because he just murdered someone in their sleep. Matt's the only one trying to get them going. And he gives them some rousing speech to get them on their feet and back off into the woods. Because they have to keep going. They have to. He knows they just have to keep going, and at some point, they are bound to find someone. There they are now. I am not exaggerating one bit. Almost immediately after saying that they're bound to find someone eventually, they turn around, and new characters just wander into the movie to save them. This movie's plot boils down to 80 minutes of, oh no, we're lost in the woods, until they're just not anymore. Like, they don't come up with some big plan to get up the cliff. They don't fight their way out of the woods on the other side to find a road. It is literally, wander, 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 oh, someone found us. It's like they went, oh, we've reached 80 minutes, I guess we're done. And they put a cap on all this with more of the really horrible looking news footage. And Matt keeps talking about how he is insistent that none of this was staged. What? Nicole's murder being staged? Going off the cliff was staged? Who cares? This entire movie is acting like you just discovered Bigfoot, and all you did was get lost in the woods because you're a bunch of dumbasses who don't know what they're doing. Which, now is a good time to circle back around to the synopsis, because I want to point out a very specific line. They find out they're willing to do anything to survive the night. Now, being fair, taking it upon yourself to kill one of your party is a pretty big move, I'll give it that. But when you have people going off into the woods, talking about how they're documenting this so people will know what happened, and you're primed with the synopsis that they will do anything to survive. This didn't even go anywhere near cannibalism, and it's staring the plot right in the face. I mean, I didn't want to see cannibalism, but you're setting it up pretty well. So, apparently there's a conspiracy theory that these people wandered into the woods and staged nothing? Like, if this was real found footage, which it's not really found because no one lost it, but getting in the weeds of details. There's no conspiracy here. It would be an easy thing to fact check. It's just such an absurd waste of a nothing burger. This is yet another movie I can't recommend anyone goes anywhere near. It could have been so much shorter, could have done so much more. There's nothing to this story. Wander into the woods for an hour until you're not lost anymore. That's it. There's no plot, there's no build-up, there's no climax. It just goes until it ends. The only thing I will say, because I always like to find the positive, it's well made and it's well shot. Genuinely, I mean that. For a found footage movie, it's not bad. I mean, aside from those bookends with the really oddly strange, terrible footage. And even though I rag on the movie a lot, the acting's not half bad. When the decision comes down that they're going to kill Nicole, the emotion of it actually feels fairly genuine. And that just about wraps up the Hulk Blood Tapes, which is still a name that baffles me, but moving on. If you have enjoyed what you've listened to, you can find more episodes on pretty much every podcasting client out there. Just do a search for The Bloodstream. We're the one that is not a medical podcast. And while you're there, leave a rating and a review. It really helps us out. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, or just have a movie that you'd like me to check out and yell at, you can always send us an email at thebloodstreampodcast@gmail.com. And don't forget, we now have a Patreon where for as low as $1 a month, you too can help support my poor life decisions. If you pledge $2 a month, you will get each and every episode several days before it reaches the main feed. So head on over to patreon.com/thebloodstream and subscribe today. So thank you for listening. I have been Jason Gray. This has been Blood Droplets. And remember, if you crash your car, just stay put and make a fire. We'll be right back. this is like all a joke. Bye.